The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus told his disciple a parable about the necessity for them to pray always without becoming weary. He said, "There was a judge in a certain town who neither feared God nor respected any human being. And a widow in that town used to come to him and say, 'Render a just decision for me against my adversary.' For a long time, the judge was unwilling, but eventually he thought, 'While it is true that I neither fear God nor respect any human being, because this widow keeps bothering me, I shall deliver a just decision for her, lest she finally come and strike me.' The Lord said, 'Pay attention to what the dishonest judge says. Will not God then secure the rights of his chosen ones who call out to him day and night? Will he be slow to answer them? I tell you, he will see to it that justice is done for them speedily. But when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth?'" The Gospel of the Lord. I've recently learned that babies, in general, babies come with a lot of capabilities that really do seem hard to believe. One that I like a lot is the reaction a baby gives when you stick out your tongue at them. When the babies are just a few days old, you know, they will stick their tongue out back at you. And it's hard to play, you know, with a newborn infant, but that's a game that I think is a lot of fun. And I never get tired of playing that game. I read about this in a scientific journal, and there's this quote. Here's this quote from the scientific article. "There is nothing cuter than a newborn sticking out their tongue in response to you doing the same." So this statement in this otherwise dull and scientific article speaks to the amazing humanity between a baby and those that care for them. So, you know, from the beginning, again, you know, I'm speaking in generalities here. Babies come with these prepackaged ways where they interact with those around them. And so one of my fondest memories from raising my daughter comes when she was 3 or 4 months old, can't remember exactly, something like that. And for some reason, I decided to say something to her like, "Haboo." And I said that to her, and then she just busted out laughing. And that was very affirming. No, people don't always laugh at my jokes. So I said, you know, I need to keep this going. So I did it again. Haboo. And this time, even more laughing. I think I kept that going until my daughter just ran out of energy. So it turns out this back and forth interaction, it's vital for babies and their development. Tragically, there's been too many cases when we see what happens when babies do not get the interaction that they need from their caregivers. There is this famous case of an experiment that was done 700 years ago. This was ordered by Frederick II, who was at the time the emperor of the Holy Roman Empire. That's what it was called at that time. And Frederick wanted to discover the natural language. You know, what would be this language if somehow it wasn't affected by the world around them or something like that? So to do that, he had 5 babies grow up together, but unaffected by any kind of natural language. And so their physical needs were cared for, but they did not get any kind of interaction with their caregivers, the mental, the emotional interaction. Consequently, sadly, all 5 babies died. And Frederick II declared that this experiment proved that humans require this emotional connection to survive. And I wonder why this was not more obvious, you know, going into that experiment. So one of the very unique characteristics of the Christian faith is the teaching on the Trinity. You have 3 separate persons, yet one God, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, They are in a relationship that is so perfect and so unified that they are one in being. So pretty soon in Mass here, we're going to recite our creedal statement, where we say that we believe that God the Father, you know, created everything, seen and unseen, and we believe that all things were created through Christ. So that means that we're about to say that we believe that God created us. And if we really believe that, that this three-person, one-in-being God created us, why would it be so hard to believe that our relationship with others would not be so vital? Our relationship with others is one of the many needs that we have. You know, we have to have oxygen, to breathe, water and food. We must have some meaningful social interaction. And the Christian God is a God of relationship, you know, within himself. He created us, and in that creation, he created our needs to be in relationship with others as well. So I just want to, just a little brief pause here, because I want to handle one potential issue at this point. It could be that some of you are recoiling at this whole idea and this homily of relationship, because you may have now, or you may have had in your past, someone who in your life that hurt you way more than they've helped you. And we have to be discerning in our relationships. It's not loving to affirm a person's harmful behavior by keeping them in your life when instead you should be protecting yourself. Now, I would not be happy if someone came along to you and said, "Hey, Deacon Robert said that you have to keep me in your life because in my evil way." You know, there are more fish in the pond. And all right, so back to what I was saying. In today's gospel reading, Jesus teaches us about the importance of remaining in relationship with God. He calls us to be constantly praying to, which means to be in communication with God. Now, why would we do that? You know, I've kind of wondered, I don't know if you've wondered, have you ever wondered how many people are going to be surprised when they get to heaven and see that, you know, God's there? You're like, "Oh, what are you doing in my paradise? Oh, I'm in your paradise. Oh, okay. I see how it's..." You know, heaven is eternal, right? And God's going to be there the whole time. I mean, that's a long time. All of eternity. So Jesus tells us to be in communication with him constantly, not only because it's good for us here on earth, but because it also gets us ready, you know, for this big transition into our heavenly home. Now, something that I found to be so much fun, just watching psychologists deal with something where, you know, lately more and more they've been having to really admit or just acknowledge this unshakable reality that a healthy spiritual life is associated with improved mental health. You know, isn't that so weird? That these things that God tells us to do align with the benefits that we see happening here on earth. Healthy relationships help us, regardless if it's with our friends, our family, or with God. You know, so here you are, you come to Mass, and you show up to church, and you're here early on a Sunday, and the deacon's being so bold as to proclaim to you that a relationship with God is a good thing. Well, you know, actually, sometimes it's not so easy. Maybe you've been abused in your life, and it's hard to trust. You might wonder why God just stood by and let these things happen to you. Well, you know, I encourage you, tell him. Tell him what you think about that. If anyone can take it, God can take it. A healthy relationship is based on honesty. And if you can't be honest if you don't share the things that confuse or anger you. Now, given our humanity, unfortunately, we both get hurt, and we end up, unfortunately, hurting others. We're kind of all in this together. And I know I've played the role too often of hurting those that I love. So at this stage in my life, I'm trying to be a force for, you know, more good and less bad. And I do some of that through my role here as a deacon at the church. You know, fortunately, I'm not alone in this effort. We're blessed to have several deacons here at All Saints. And I'll just mention, once again, we have the second collection coming, and It's used to pay for the many years of education that candidates receive on their way, God willing, to becoming a deacon. So I encourage you to consider playing a vital role in that process by helping us out financially. Now, in today's gospel reading, it's about healthy relationships and the importance of healthy communication. Through his word and example, God tells us that we should spend a significant amount of our time and energy encouraging our relationship with him. In today's reading, he's not telling us what to say, but I am suggesting that you consider speaking honest words to God. If you're overjoyed with gratitude, speak that. It's honest. But if you stayed away from your relationship with God because you're afraid to say something unpleasant, yet completely honest, I encourage you to say those things.